Recent headlines have stated that there are troubling times in store for the national parks. The future of the national parks is unclear and possibly in jeopardy. But amidst the troubles lies the Ice Age Trail Alliance in Cross Plains, Wisconsin. Its purpose? To maintain and keep interest in over its 1,200-mile-long trail.
Well, first of all, it's one of only a few national scenic trails in the United States. In particular, the Ice Age Trail is special because it interprets very unique and dramatic glacial effects on the land. You can see the effects of a glacier that left over 10,000 years ago.
Our story deals with glaciers, you know, and that's what we're interpreting or helping people interpret is this glacial story of the state. But even more so, I think, is that the proximity to just a large number of people to access this feature. So whether you live in Milwaukee or Madison or Wausau or the Twin Cities or Chicago, you're within less than an hour of this resource.
Like many other national parks, the Ice Age Trail itself is also in a funding crisis.
And we're all kind of struggling to stay afloat.
In 2014 alone, the Ice Age Trail alliances were greater than their revenue by over $8,500. Additionally, the federal, state, and other governmental contributions to the funding made up less than 40% of the funding for the alliance that year.
I think what reduced funding really does is it misses opportunities that we have.
In a way, it sometimes makes the people who are devoted to the trail divert their efforts away from building and maintaining the trail to more promotion and fundraising.
And on top of the lack of funding, only 600 miles of the trail is completed, only half the length of a 1,200-mile trail. The rest of the land that would complete the trail either belongs to private landowners or is in need of construction. The alliance needs money to purchase the land from private landowners.
Realistically, I don't think it will happen in my children's lifetimes. My kids are in their mid-20s.
The significance of national parks plays a fundamental role in many states' economies, Wisconsin included. Hikers on the Ice Age Trail inject nearly $113 million into Wisconsin's economy each year.
We know the average person, day hiker, is spending $78 when they go out to hike somewhere through gas and lunch and whatever else they may need to have that experience.
They go to coffee shops, they buy groceries, whatever happens to be.
You know, when you get a small community like this, Cross Plains, for instance, is a trail community. It has identified the trail as an asset to the community from a standpoint of recreation, education, peace, solace, exercise, and what have you.
So what is the Ice Age Trail's response to filling in the gaps of defunding? Well, thanks to the hard work of volunteers, for now, some of that gap is being filled.
There's no shortage of things that are done by volunteers to do it, but I think, you know, the thing that drives my work the most is just that spirit that they bring to everything, and that's just love of the trail and the people along it and the route, the landscape. That's what's so motivating to me.
Because no communities or government agencies could afford to put the amount of time in that volunteers collectively do.
Without the volunteers, there wouldn't be a trail.
This is Angie Rueda reporting for PBS Student Reporting Labs.